so what we're doing now is datoing the edge of these boards for the trim piece that's kind of formed like that to grab down onto it. So we got to dato it and cut it, the rabbit on the jointer over there.
Looks good.
Nice Freud dado blade. Makes a difference when it's sharp.
It's whooping. Only trouble is it doesn't know the difference between the wood and your fingers.
Right.
Utmost care.
They've got it. There's a saw on the market that does though.
Yeah, yeah, I mean, I saw that.
You can take a hot dog and it'll shut it down immediately. All right.
That's looking good, man.
So, let's go ahead and cut the rabbit on that so he can get that on there. Now we got the data.
Go ahead. Go ahead and saw.
You still on? Okay. So now that we got the dados, we're going to wrap it. The edges to take what little bit we have to off on that.
Count for the thickness of the.
Hey, Claude, you want to get the back?
What now?
I'll turn the dust collector on.
Other way.
Go slow.
Not very nice.
No, it doesn't. It's different. But there's nothing to do. You gotta go this way.
Ah, man.
At least it won't be chipping the edge. It's the main thing.
Right.
Alright, see what it looks like. Yeah, much better. Much better.
All right, here we go. Got it all milled up. So hopefully it'll work out. I think it's going to, don't you, Matt?
I think so.
It'll be pretty. Got to get some satin out exterior type finish on it. General finishes. So there's the new, out with the old. Out with the old, in with the new. Later. All right, I got all this wormy maple in here, ready to start sanding it. I sand it with, I could probably start with 220, and then go to 320. Might finish it out at 400 and then I'll put the top coat on it, which is an exterior urethane made by General Finishes. So got all these laid out here and I'm ready to get to work. See you in a bit.
We'll be right back.
they call snipe right here. That's where the planer grabs the board and it creates a little bit of an uneven surface right there. A little bit high right here. Cuts a little bit more than the rest of the board when it first goes in. So gotta sand that out so it won't show. Especially when the finish goes on. Disappears. Then go over the whole thing with the standard flap, so it's a nice smooth flap surface now. So what I'm doing is I'm sanding with 120, then I'm going to 220, and then I'll sand by hand with 220. I'm gonna stop at 220 because the finish actually says it's better to put the finish on there at 220. It gets a better bite into the substrate, and then sand between coats with 320 to smooth things up. So got five down and three to go. So see you in a bit. Got my helpers with me now. Hey, Carter.
Hi.
All right, we got it ready. We're getting ready to spray some General Finishes Exterior 450 Satin on there. Probably get three coats on today. Then level sand the boards and flip them over and do a few coats tomorrow. But Carter, don't touch it and we'll brush it off. So we are ready to put some finish on this. All right, here we go. There's one coat. I'm gonna give it about an hour or so to dry real good, and then I'll level sand it with 400, or at least scuff sand it. Probably gonna put three coats on, see where it's at, maybe put two more coats on tomorrow. And I gotta do the other side as well. So, all right, there you go. All right, I let this sit up for a couple days, and now I'm wet sanding it with a 500 Averlon pad, and so I got a little bit of popcorn from the ceiling on this one. Decided to fall down out of there. Anyway, that's been going on for years. So I'm wet sanding using this DA and a 500 Averlon pad. Get those wet sand, and then I'll put a couple more coats of the exterior 450 on them. See you in a bit. Okay, I've got the bedwood all done now. Just got it up here in my office area so I can just let it cure out until I'm ready to install it. And got, what, five pieces there, two there, one back here. There's my tailgate. Got to finish the, redo the lettering on the front on that, as mentioned earlier. But yeah, I think it turned out pretty good. Let's get it over here in the light. Nice satin finish on it. I'll probably rub it out with probably a 2000 grit Averlon and some wax like I do my drums when I make those. And it should be pretty nice. And so it's got... three good heavy coats on the back,
And then I put three coats on the front and level sanded and put two more coats. So it's got the equivalent, I guess, maybe four coats on it, but should be good. It feels feels pretty well protected. So just have to, you know, keep it dry for the most part. If it does get wet, it's not a big deal, but it's not gonna be parked outside anyhow. So, all right, so the bedwood is ready to go in, and now I'm just gonna be working on little odds and ends, install glass, and wait until my friend Claude gets back from the holiday celebration in Kansas, and we'll put the bed together. All right, catch you guys next time. Bye.